بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. My dear brothers and sisters, we are living in a time where popularity is a standard for some people, a standard of approval. That if someone has a lot of followers or if someone is very popular, that hey man, look at them, come on, how of course they're accepted, of course Allah loves them because look how many followers they have, look how many, how popular it is. The concept of popularity or having kuthra, or you know, having a lot, is something, or being followed by a lot, or being popular, okay, ma'roof, is something that is in many cases misguided. And I will attempt to show you today why. And the objective of this video is because this extends to other practices in our societies, and including the Muslim countries. So a lot of people say, well, what's wrong? Everyone's doing it. Like, it must be. And they're Muslim. Look, they're Muslim. Why are you being so extreme in talking about this, or in attacking that, or bringing this issue out? Well, look at all the Muslims are doing it. And this appeal to popularity, you can say, or to the numbers, or because there's so many people doing it, therefore it must be right, is a fallacy. And if we look into our own issues in our own society, around the Muslim society, when it comes to social media, again, how many views someone has, how many followers they have, all of a sudden then they must have a correct path, right? I mean, come on, would Allah allow them to have such qabul or acceptance? People think like that. Then they extend it to, of course, other stuff, behavior. So we live today in a constant bombarding with you know, TikTok challenges and all kinds of challenges, right? You see these challenges, right? The dances and different things. And the Muslims have their own challenges. And if you tell someone, bro, like, this is not, you know, this new culture is not so good, or this trend that you're starting around is haram. Oh, who are you to think? Haram police or haram police? This issues of haram police are being invoked a lot. And again, it's not correct. It's incorrect, actually. Just because you label someone does not make it correct. But we find the label. That's the easiest thing. Instead of attacking the argument, instead of dealing with the issue, we basically label stuff and we dismiss things. So we have these social media challenges, these trends that happen amongst the Muslims, the dances of the Muslim women, where, you know, everyone has to respond to these challenges, families participating in these challenges, brothers allowing their women, their wives, to perform in front of the screen for other men to see, while you can clearly see them, they themselves being in this. And then they check, oh, you know, how are we doing? So social media wise, do we get followers? You know, the whole, you know, special Muslim, cute couples, whatnot. These kind of trends are huge followers. And again, if you dare to say, bro, that's like a problem. Oh, who are you to think that? Who are you to say that? Why do people follow such trends, which are clearly against Islam? Again, if I say clearly against Islam, people will be like, oh, here we go, the haram police. Here we go, he's trying to build followers by attacking people. So I'm not attacking or naming anyone, but you can see these challenges, these popular accounts that so many people follow, these funny skits where the guy is shaking from the girl and the girl is doing all kinds of things, or the girl talks in a guy's voice, if you want to be this, then you should be a this. And you know, these TikToks, Instagram, popular Muslim accounts where they've lift off, you know what I mean? But the bottom line is, people think because they're popular, that they are somehow, okay, they're right. And one of the reasons, the psychological implications of the popularity of these accounts and these people, these trends, these cultures, are of course that they provide entertainment. And if you look at how many there are out there, the imitations, because of course it was the non-Muslims who started a lot of these trends. And the Muslims, slowly they pick it up, they just Islamicize it. They think if they put a hijab on it, or a beard on it, or a halal stamp on it, all of a sudden it's permissible. It's not. Just because you put the word Muslim in front of something, Muslim vibes, Muslim vines, Muslim TikTok, halal, you know, this, halal, that. You know, you find this account. People think already, khalas. I mean, it says halal, bro. I mean, come on, what's wrong with it, right? She's wearing hijab, bro. What's wrong? Bro, he's got a beard. What's wrong with it? Look, it's not like that. This is very superficial. But the issue is the kathratul khabith. Okay, there's a lot of this khabith, yani this garbage. It is garbage. I mean, khabith is like dirty. Khabith is evil. Khabith is something not right. And khabith in the Arabic language has a certain implication. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 100, كُلَّ لَا يَسْتَوِي الْخَبِيثُ وَالطَّيِّبُ وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثُ. Say, O Prophet, good and evil, or dirty and clean. لا يستوي الخبيث والطيب ولو أعجبك كثرة الخبيث. And even though the increase or the popularity of the trash would incite you or impress you. So trash and clean, good and evil, I mean evil and good are not the same. لا يستوي. Say it's not the same. وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثِ. And even though the kathra, the increase, the popularity of this kind of culture, this kind of things that are haram. I mean, you know, don't tell me you put a woman shaking her thing out there and you as a husband, you think that is permissible, that this is right. Now, I'm not calling you garbage or her stuff. Don't say that and don't think that. But the concept of what these trends, these challenges that are so popular everywhere, millions of views, everyone's joining. I've seen father, daughter, husband, wife jumping on these things. Okay? Why? Because they get ajabaka. And it's ajib. It incites you. You are attracted to it. You've been impressed by it. أَعْجَبَكَ يعني something. In Arabic, when you say أَعْجَبَكَ شَيْ, it's like it impressed you. You like it. Like if you like a woman, for example, she, you know, أَعْجَبَكَ, you know, this, okay, this woman. So these things impress you because they're entertainment, right? And you like and you press and you this. So indeed, subhanAllah, the ayah is correct. كُلَّا يَسْتَوِي الْخَبِيثُ وَالطَّيِّبُ وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثُ. They are not the same. Good and evil is not the same. A lecture about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about remembering the names of Allah, about the aqidah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the correct fiqh or the correct way, and tafsir of an ayah, you know, looking at Qurtubi, Ibn Kathir or Ibn Abbas saying this, Ibn Umar, the opinions of the scholars is not the same as these TikTok and Instagram challenges. Yet what do people like? Compare a video of the scholars of knowledge of the Kibar al-Ulama, for example, and a video of some of these, you know, so-called influencers, Muslim influencers. Okay? Compare that and see the difference. Why? Because وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثِ. There's a lot of it. It's popular. It's become a culture. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. So fear Allah, يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Oh, people of understanding, people of brain. Those who have brain, they say, wait a second, this is a joke. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. So that you may, inshallah, be successful, succeed, win. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Oh, people of intellect. When you look at this, wait a second, shaking the back and this and that, and putting my wife shaking her back on Instagram, on TikTok, and doing funny skits and all that, and everyone's watching. If it has 2 million views, it means 2 million, most likely over a million men have watched her. And this is wrong, man. Where's your chivalry? Where's your positive jealousy, your protective jealousy? It's not there. So I want you to really pay attention to this ayah. وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثِ. Even though these increase, even though they impress you, even though it's a popular culture, even though people do it. قُلْ لَا يَسْتَوِي. لَا يَسْتَوِي. They're not equal. They're not the same. Of course, one is clear, clean, good. The other one is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خبيث. Do you understand طيب? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He has given us halal and طيب. We eat what's halal and clean. Actually, the word طيب is clean. The opposite here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the word خبيث. Even in normal Arabic, خبيث means it is something dirty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect. So just because something is popular does not make a difference. People try to say sometimes, even amongst the popular opinions of things that are happening in the West, people will cite, for example, the ayah in the Quran, chapter 4, verse 115. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but he whom breaks with the messenger after guidance has come clear to him and allows other than the way of the believers or follows other than the way of the believers, we shall consign to what he had turned to and roast in Jahannam, an evil home coming. So even one of the scholars was asked about the proof for ijma, for consensus. And he quoted this hadith. So some people think that, this look, you know, this is the way of the believers. The Muslims are doing these challenges. The Muslims are saying Merry Christmas. The Muslims in our community are doing this and that. Who are you to come and say otherwise? An Imam so-and-so said that this is ijma. There's ijma amongst the community. For those who study usul al-fiqh, they know what ijma is. And actually, even then, it's such a deep thing. This is not the ijma of the lame people, or of the lay people, sorry, of the awam, as we say. You're talking here about scholars, if they have ijma. We're talking here about binding ijma, which may be just the sahaba ijma. This is a talk about the scholars. This is not about lay people. It's not the awam. Oh yeah, in our community, we do this. And you come all of a sudden, you know, you're breaking the ijma. A'udhu billah. Actually, it's not about the group. It's not about how many. It's about who has the truth. It is about who has the truth, my brothers and sisters. It's not about, everyone's doing it. And it's not just everyone. No, it's Sheikh so-and-so from so-and-so Institute has said this. And we follow him, of course. He has, look how many followers he has. How many followers do you have, brother? Oh, you're trying to get followers now. No, please, for God's sake. Okay, one last thing. Umar Khattab, Al-Qurtubi reports from Umar Khattab radiallahu anhu. He heard a man saying something. He said, "Oh Allah, make me amongst the few. Oh Allah, make me amongst the few." So Umar said, "What is this supplication? What is this supplication?" The man said, "I refer to the saying of Allah, the Exalted, and few of my servants are grateful." Okay? وَقَلِيلُ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. Okay? A few of my servants are grateful. This is chapter 34, verse 13. Umar radiallahu anhu said then, "All of the people know better than you, O Umar." And this is the Tafsir al-Qurtubi for the ayah 34, 13. Subhanallah. So look at that. Why? Because Allah says in many cases, there's not only this ayah, other cases about the qaleel and the kathir. And I urge you to look at that. Is it about the how many people and that's an evidence for truth? Or is it that the truth is actually its evidence? It's about the truth and it's not about the numbers. It is about the truth. The truth stands out from falsehood, as Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah. Okay, so don't follow just the trends. Don't follow just the fashion just because, oh, he has a lot of followers or she has a lot of followers, must be doing something right. Allah loves him. This is a sign of Allah's love for him. It's not, right? And especially with these trends, these fashions of Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, whatever it is, be careful with this, brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the truth. And as Umar Khattab said, you know, he basically said, "Oh Allah, make me amongst the few, the ones who follow the truth." And it doesn't matter if me, anyone, ever does anything against Allah and His Messenger, Quran, Sunnah, Subhanallah. Sometimes you can almost say that, man, I'm sure people will like defend me. I'm sure that amongst my followers, people, if anyone calls me on it, people defend me. Why? Because it's this culture. I'm not trying to insult anyone who likes my work and stuff. But if I do something wrong, I see sometimes people like defending. Sometimes people advise me, and people are like, "Oh, who are you to tell me?" That's not the correct attitude. And that's not the correct attitude to be taken with other people just because they're so popular and anyone dares to say, "Bro, this is not right. Oh, who are you to say? Why this? Why that?" No, it's the truth. Do we follow the truth or not? That is the criteria, okay? Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.